On today's webcast, I'll be going over the following. We're first going to discuss what is the DSR. We're then going to go over the DSR submission requirements. We're going to go over what's new in 2022 and the DRP and CBDPP submission steps. We'll discuss how to complete the DSR and the available technical assistance resources available to everyone. And then we'll have Q&A at the end. All right, so let's get started. For those new to the DSR, let's first establish what the DSR is. The DSR is designed to collect data from accredited pre- and postdoctoral dental education programs and dental hygiene education programs regarding oral health services provided to people with HIV. The DSR is used by two programs under the Ryan White HIV/AIDS Treatment Extension Act of 2009, the Dental Reimbursement Program and the Community-Based Dental Partnership Program. The DSR submission requirements are different for DRP institutions versus CBDPP recipients. DRP institutions applying for dental reimbursement funding must submit a completed report annually to receive assistance with their unreimbursed costs of care incurred in providing direct oral health services. CBDPP grant recipients use this report to submit annual program data, which is one of the terms of the grant award. New this year, the DSR data are now submitted via a web-based platform. Registration to the site is available starting on December 17, 2021. I'll be demoing where to register, but step-by-step guidance is also available in the DSR instruction manual. I've posted this as a handout to today's webinar, so you all should have access to download that. It's also being posted to the HRSA-HAB webpage, as well as the Target Center. So there's a number of locations where this resource is available, but if you're unable to find it, you can reach out to technical assistance at the end of the webcast and we'll get it out to you. So if you're a DRP institution applying for reimbursement, you must complete the following steps. You'll register for the DSR website. You'll enter data for services provided between July 1st, 2020 through June 30th, 2021. And this goes in the program contacts and sections 1-4 of the DSR. You'll submit the DSR, and if applicable, you'll print a copy for your records, and you'll also submit the SF-424 via grants.gov. For our CBDPP recipients, you must complete the following steps. So you'll also register for the DSR website. You'll enter data for services provided between January 1st through December 31st, 2021, also into program contacts in sections 1-4 of the DSR. You'll submit the DSR and, if applicable, print a copy for your records. So now that we've established what the DSR is and who should be completing it, I'll now open the system for our demonstration. All right, so this is what our new landing page looks like, or rather our login page. Please disregard this URL. This is our testing environment. You will not be granted access to this. As a reminder, that registration doesn't begin until the 17th. All right, so it looks exactly the same. Eventually, when you are able to register, you'll click this link here, registration form here, and you will fill out these fields. So if you're with a CBDPP, you'll keep the yes here, and you'll enter your organization's grant number or name. This will auto-populate after we've added your organization, so you will be affiliated with your specific organization. And then you'll fill in some user information here, your email address, first name, last name, et cetera. DRP, same thing, but make sure you click no to register for your specific organization. If you have any issues, please contact data support. All right, so let's go back here. All right, so I already have my demonstration account. The system does use two-factor authentication. My chosen method is text message, so I just received that code on my cell phone. All right, so this is the landing page. You will see any announcements here, any special notifications from HAB or technical assistance or otherwise. We'll be on this landing page. All right. So once you're here, depending on the organization you registered with, if you are a CDPP that also completes the DRP, you will see both reports here. This is how I've set up this registration for today's demonstration purpose. But we'll begin with the My Organization info. This is all display only. If there are any changes that need to be made here, you'll need to contact data support and we can make those updates as necessary. If you're completing the DRP, you'll find your report under this reports tab. It's just a drop-down menu that you'll select from here. And you'll select the submission period. So as we continue to use the system, they will all be archived here, but it will default to the most recent reporting period. For today's purposes, I've only created the one submission period. And as a note, you have to complete these sections in order. So there's no skipping ahead here to complete section 4. You'll receive this notification banner at the top saying complete the sections in order. So I'm going to go back here, program contacts, and these are all the same fields that used to be collected in the Microsoft Access database. They're just now in a web-based system. And as in the past, sections 1 through 3 are the same for each report. It's section 4 that varies between the DRP and the CBDPP. So DRPs, you will input your unreimbursed costs. And please note, there's a tab-based system. Again, this is similar to how the Microsoft Access database worked. And these must also be completed sequentially. And if you encounter any validation, so again, in the past, those would have been done after all the data was entered. Now they happen as you are completing the sections. So you'll enter in the data for each of these three tabs. There'll be the option to save. And if you encounter any validations, they will pop up in a banner at the top, just like you see here. All right, so CBDPP agencies, you'll also click reports and go to your CBDPP report. And as I mentioned, section 4 is the differentiator here. You will add your member organizations into this section 4 tab. All right, so once all of your data is entered, it has to be error-free to proceed with submission. If you have any questions about validations, data support will be available to assist with those, and our contact information will be displayed at the end of today's presentation. But since I don't have data entered here, I'm going to pull up page 17 of the manual real quick. So this, what are we calling this? Sorry, we're calling this the status report. So once you click submit, picture this as a submit button. Once all of your data is entered, you will see this table here, and it will show the user address and the date and time of when it was submitted. If you identify some data needs to be revised after it's submitted but before the report deadline, you'll now be able to request unsubmit within the web system. Data support reviews these requests and will be able to return it to working status. And again, this is all captured in this submission status table. And then to print for your records, once it's in a submitted status, you'll also have the print button here. And just to make this more clear here, this table will eventually be here where my cursor is. And this is all after you've entered your data in those fields. All right, so last but not least, I mentioned the resources are also available for download here. You'll click the resources in this navigation bar. And then you'll be able to download this file. You can see it automatically downloads to your computer based on your computer's preferences. If you have any changes that you need to make to your profile, you'll use the drop-down from your email address, My Profile. This is where you can change your password, change your multi-factor authentication. We've got text message, a voice call, or the Google Authenticator app options, and then any of your contact information here. All right, so that is our new web-based reporting system. I'm going to go back to our presentation. All right, so these are the demo, what I just demoed. This slide deck will be available for download, and we'll also have a recording of the webinar. So you'll be able to access this at your leisure, or if you have additional questions from today's broadcast, you can go review this in about 2 weeks. All right, so please take note, this year's DSR deadline is Friday, March 11th, 2022. And lastly, this table shows the technical assistance contact information and the type of technical assistance each contact provides. As I mentioned, I'm with the data support team, and we address DSR-related content and submission questions. This includes interpretation of the DSR instruction manual and HABS reporting requirements, step-by-step instructions for registering and completing the DSR in the new web system, data validation questions, and any general questions about the DSR. The HRSA-HAB website has downloadable copies of the DSR instruction manual. For CVDPP recipients, programmatic questions should be directed to your project officer. And for DRP institutions, if you have questions regarding the submission of the SF-424, those questions should be directed to grants.gov